Sports presents the Professional Bowlers Tour. From the heart of the Southwest, Grand Prairie, Texas, next door to the Big D, Dallas. This ABC Sports exclusive is brought to you by Quaker State, made from Pennsylvania-grade crude oil, new and old cars, small and big cars, staying on the road with Quaker State. By New Tempo, the antacid that's made soft to dissolve fast and work hard, and it doesn't taste chalky or gritty. Remarkable New Tempo. And by Light Beer from Miller, everything you always wanted in a beer and less. Listen to that crowd, ladies and gentlemen. Here at the Forum Bowl, our Knights return to this friendly, warm city of Grand Prairie, Texas. And what warmth we get from proprietress Jeannie Halsey and her staff. I'm Chris Schenkel, and delighted to be on these approaches again. Last year I missed it because I was off in Japan doing gymnastics. This is a lot more fun, I must admit. And we're happy to be in the ancestral roots of the Burton family. Nelson Burton Jr. is one of the offsprings. Bo?
Well, thank you, Chris. I have to admit that my mother sang "The Eyes of Texas Are Upon You" many a time when I was younger. And you're right about this field. It follows the same saga that we've seen so far in 1983. The name players, Anthony, Holman, Roth, Webb, they're not here. And there's two reasons. They're a little older. These young guys are getting sharper, more experienced. And I think the big reason is that the lane conditions that the PBA is putting out today on the tour is very diversified, and it makes it difficult for anybody to dominate as we saw in the past decade.
What about scores on this championship pair? Will it be high or not so high?
Well, for the right-handers, Chris, they can keep the ball in the track area. I think they'll carry real well. The off hit is not easy to carry here at Forum Lanes, but if they can keep it solid in pocket, the winner of the Quaker State Open will deserve the title.
Nice going on finishing 13th.
Thank you.
Nelson Burton Jr. Okay. It's time now to meet the five finalists, one of whom will win the $20,000 first prize. In fifth place, the defending champion here at Grand Prairie, a native of Fresno, California, Art Trask. In fourth place, Rick Vitone, 26 years old, from Salem, Oregon, looking for his first PBA title. A familiar name on the tour in third place, Guppy Troop from Jacksonville, Florida. In second place, a five-time winner, Tom Baker, 28 years old, from Buffalo, New York. And our tournament leader, Ted Hannes, 25 years old, from Zanesville, Ohio, looking for his second PBA title on the Professional Bowlers Tour. All right, we're now ready for our first match live coverage from the Forum. Rick Vitone is on the left. He will meet the defending champion on the right, a winner here a year ago, Art Trask of Fresno, California. Oldest in the field at 34, winner of three PBA titles, has been a member of that organization for 11 years. He is in the fifth spot, going against Vitone, who finished fourth. The winner to meet, Guppy Troop.
And Art Trask of Fresno continues that.
We will move up our stepladder format. Now let's get a look at 26-year-old Rick Vitone. Born and lives in Salem, Oregon. The only bachelor in the field of five. Had quite a backswing. Watch it.
So, Nelson Burton, we're all even after one frame.
Chris, the format here at the Quaker State Open was a 42-game format. The players started with the Pro-Am on Tuesday. As you see the stats on Rick Vitone, they start on Tuesday with a 160-man field, 18 qualifying games. The top 24 went at it, down to the top five today. Rick Vitone was here last year. He knows how to win.
All right, on the left lane of this championship pair, going for a double. All but the five on the left lane for Vitone, who's looking for his first PBA title. Watch the pinfall as we replay the result of the shot.
Head pin goes to the sideboard and takes out the 2, 4, and doesn't quite get the 5. There it goes, gets the 4, knocks out the 7. We said earlier at the top of the telecast that the off hit is difficult to carry, but you carry the solid pocket hit almost every shot.
All right, Rick Vitone marking with a spare in the second frame. He finished fourth here last year. And, of course, as we indicated earlier, Art Trask won the Quaker State Open. So he's trying to successfully defend it. Strike up, shooting in the second frame. All but the seven, disbelief, Art Trask.
A hit we haven't seen on the telecast all this year, the solid seven. The two-pin goes to sideboard and actually paralyzes the four before it gets to the seven, a bad break for Trask.
Trask last year, sixth on the money list, 92 grand. This year, Art has earned $3,105. And as we indicated, the first prize is $20,000, $11,000 for second, $7,500 third, $6,000 for fourth. The loser of this first match, will receive $5,000. All even after two full frames in the first game. Standing room only crowd here at the Forum. The bowling establishment with more chandeliers than I've seen since staying at the Plaza Hotel in New York. A four pin for Trask.
As the ball enters the pocket slightly high, watch the two pin. That's the third pin on the left-hand side of your screen. Go to the sideboard, goes between the four and seven, but doesn't quite knock out the four. When we get the trip four, the two pin does the damage.
Continuing to mark are our two professionals, our first in this field of five. Three of the five were in last year's televised finals. And Bo, it must have been quite an event.
It was, Chris, and the characteristics our lanes come through, the track area, the worn area, that's why these fellows have been so consistent over a two-year period.
Crossing over. Salem, Oregon's professional on the tour, who last year won $26,000, has $660 this year. Been sort of off and on in the tour, but has been back for this starting his second year again. And I would think with his success, he'll stay out here and try to win some of the multi-million dollars offered by the Professional Bowlers Association. Isn't he smooth? Rick Vitone of Salem, Oregon. Our first match is underway. Action will continue. We're looking at Art Trask.
And we see, Chris, the traditional type of arm swing of Art Trask. You see shoulder level, very disciplined, in an excellent position right across there. See a good high follow through. Now watch Rick Vitone, who is a contemporary young player. See the difference in his arm swing as he generates more power and more speed to bowl on today's urethane conditions. Look at the height of that backswing compared to Art Trask. Both are getting the job done, both excellent players.
As a result of Vitone's double, he has an 11-pin lead. Trask shooting in the fourth, a spare working. Our first match from the Forum, Grand Prairie, Texas. A 4-7 for Trask.
Good point of style with Art Trask is watch how he keeps his eyes on his target and holds his follow through until the ball's well down the lane. That's such a good disciplinary measure. Keeps you from pulling up on the shot and cutting it short.
Nelson, as a tip, in other words, be careful whose style you copy.
Well, I think you have to stay with your own. It's much like a baseball pitcher. You take your natural rhythm. You have to have certain proper body position, as Melanie Trask looks on. Art's wife flew in from Fresno, California. And, Chris, I would say for any person, whether it be young or old, develop the style that you have and stick with it as a natural style, but still hold your follow-through. That works for everybody.
All right. You see a lot of steady heads on the professionals today. There's one of them. The result, a strike.
Art Trask from Fresno, the defending champion. You can take a breather now as 26-year-old Rick Pitone is up. Great fan of the Portland Trail Blazers. Using not too much of the approach, way to the left of center. Ten pin.
That's the shot we were talking about, the ball not quite finishing solid. Steve Fair just missed the top 25, Chris, by one pin. He needed a strike in the 10th frame of the 42nd game, left the difficult 4-9 split, converted it, and got a strike, but he was just one pin short. I'll bet you he can find that somewhere in 42 games.
He's a heck of a bowler. Russ Lane. Well done. And here in our first match, going through five frames, and Vitone has a 12-pin lead. Winner to meet Guppy Troop, colorful Guppy Troop.
That's the shot we were talking about that Fair left. He needed a strike to make the championship round. Right now, Vitone had it. What happens is the ball is in the tracker worn area leading the pocket. It just breaks too sharply as it enters the 1-3, cuts through, no break on the 4-pin.
...tagged as he was in the 8th inning. He gave up 2 hits, he walked 3, one of the hits...
Conclusion of this first match, the winner to me... It's a high hit and leaves the 3-10 on the right lane.
The players this week try to keep the ball between the second and third area. There's a worn or track area on the right side of the lane, and it's been very playable for the right-handers this week. No left-handers in the top 24. The simple fact that the righties had the advantage by being able to keep the ball in the track or area between the first, second, and third arrow.
Beautifully done. And when we see the high backswing of Rick Vitone, we think of Pete Weber, who finished 28th, Holman 30th, Roth 31st.
Just touches the 3-pin on the right side, lets the ball do the work. Into the 10. Great shot. He still trails by 8 pins. 8th frame coming up.
Establishment, a bowling center in Salem, Oregon. Now a 34-year-old who was born in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, Art Trask.
Trask also the fingertip grip with finger grippers for extra support, and they're both players are using the polyester bowling ball today.
And leaving the 6-10 on this right lane of the championship pair in a bowling center that has 60 lanes.
Good break by Trask, cuts through. Normally you leave the 4-6-10 on this. The 2-pin pushes out the 4-7. The 6-10, got to avoid the chop, keep the speed up. Art was just slow on that very first shot.
So Art Trask remains clear, clean in every frame, with the 9th frame coming up, holding a 6-pin lead. You win, you move up. You lose, you get a $5,000 check.
No, no.
We have a wireless mic on Art, and you heard him say, oh, no. Well, the 4-7-10, something to contend with.
Can turn the match around. The 4-7-10, Art Trask needs to take the 4-pin and slide it all the way over to the 10-pin. He wants to hit on the outside of the 4-pin and slide it over into the 10.
Got a 3-10 conversion by Art's opponent. Let's see now. Here's his shot. Obviously, he really went for it. 167 through nine frames, Bo.
Match play, Chris, and this is the point where you really have to put it to your opponent. Art Trask has opened the door for Rick Pitone. Rick Pitone, with a strike working, could take a 19-pin lead and just about shut out Art Trask. This is the big shot of the match.
Oh, lost it at the line.
And you don't think that the pressure affects you? Unbelievable. That high backswing, we've seen that one more time. Unbelievable. The high backswing, he loses it on the downswing, and the ball just drops off, drops in the right channel. That happened one other time, Chris. Young mm-hmm. Pete Weber at Garden yes. City 2 years ago did the same thing with that high backswing like that.
Okay, the fans here
see
trying
he lost
to
it.
Get the adrenaline flowing for this 26-year-old from Salem, Oregon.
He has to recollect his thoughts, take a feel of that grip again, and if he can make the spare, will maintain that 9-pin lead. Remember, he had a strike working. This is as good as 9 if he can make the spare.
Needs a pocket hit. Valiant try.
So that, what a turnaround. It, from leading by 9 pins, he also, he drops right behind in this match. He drops to 4 pins behind. So what has happened are 3 pins behind with that open frame, Chris.
And he has gone over to check the score sheet of our tournament director, Harry Golden. Trask just sort of looks away, checking with Harry Golden and Paramus' own Frank Esposito.
Pitone needs 2 strikes to take the lead.
Outgoing bowling fans here at the Forum in Grand Prairie.
Just saws that 5 off. The ball comes in, hits the 1-3. Watch it drive right into the 5-pin, 5 over into the 7. He has a chance to regain the lead with another strike.
The winner of this match, still in doubt, will meet Guppy Troop.
He thought he had it. Got a little extra on the ball. Didn't get the break on the 4. The best Rick Pitone can roll is 184. It forces Art Trask to get a spare and an 8 count.
Now Trask is up.
Needs a spare and 8. Strike on the first ball would just about ensure victory.
3-time champion. Crossover strike. 10th frame for Art Trask. Well, he'll have to better the 184 shot by Rick Pitone, and shouldn't have any problem.
8 pins on 2 balls. When you need just a count or even a mark, Chris, just go for the pocket. There is no safety shot. He knows where the pocket is. He has to build his speed up. He's gotten slow the last 2 frames of this match. He may get lucky, but to win the next match, he's going to keep up the speed.
Just like that, 10 with the first ball, and it's a victory for Art Trask. That means that he's one step closer to defending his Quaker State Open title. Next, Trask and Troop. The Professional Bowlers Tour will continue after this message from one of our sponsors and station identification. Art Trask defeating Rick Pitone, 195 to 184. Trask with 5 strikes. Last year, it was Pitone that met Guppy Troop for the fourth place spot, our second match a year ago, but now it's Trask, the defending champion, that will go against Troop. It'll be Trask shooting first.
The championship pair, the left-hand lane, is just a touch tighter than the right-hand lane. Most of the left-hand lanes in this house hook more, but on this particular pair, the players can go straighter at the pocket on the left-hand lane, giving a little room on the right.
Okay, there we go.
Well, you heard him, he loved it. He liked it. Well, it's a great way to start his second match, Trask with a strike. And now a look at 33-year-old Guppy Troop. Jacksonville, Florida, born in Edinburgh, Scotland. Came to the States when he was 4 years old. And the man with half and half slacks leaves the four pin.
Guppy with a very short backswing. He's probably the most successful player on the tour to play the outside line consistently because he's so straight through the ball. Watch his hand action. Just right up the back of the ball, a simple flip, not much hook.
Golf finish on that blue bowling ball used by Guppy Troop here in our second match. Last week at the Showboat, Guppy finished in a tie with Tommy Hudson for 10th place, finished 145th in Anaheim, 53rd at the AC Delco Classic in Alameda. Boy, has he moved up.
Has a great arm swing, always keeps it in play, very seldom ever beats himself.
Action track tracer of his shot.
You'll see Guppy Troop playing out right down the second arrow, the edge of that tracker worn area we're talking about, right into 1-3 pocket, but very little hook. Look, as the action track tracer shows you, very little hook to the pocket, almost straight in.
Hoping for a double is Trask now. Second frame, second game.
Get up, ball.
There you see the little microphone by the buttons on his shirt. Wireless. And our incredible audio engineers picking up what he says. Spare in the second.
I believe that Art Trask has the best shot to hit the 1-3 pocket, but his carry may not be as good as Guppy Troop's. On the last shot, we saw the inside line near the third arrow that Art Trask is playing. Didn't quite get enough angle on the 5 to knock out the 7. But to hit the pocket, you have to stay inside to consistent. Guppy Troop's going for the carry. Art's asking for a second re-rack.
He'll need the permission of Harry Golden.
And he called the 3-pin left. That's the key pin, really, for a pro bowler. If the ball hits the 1 and 3 at the exact same time, that's when you often get the 8-10 split. In order to get optimum carry, the ball must hit the head pin first, then the 3-pin. But if they hit them exactly at the same instance, that's when the ball is paralyzed and does not finish through the pins.
Come on, ball carry.
Well, his wishes were answered, and those of his wife, Melanie. Art Trask, if you just joined us, he won the first match against Rick Vitone, 195 to 184. Now, Guppy Troop. Eighth last year in the money earnings, 87,688. 9-year member, 5 titles. Blue bowling ball, taking them all out.
Guppy's new wife, Dee, looks on. They've been married for 6 weeks. Guppy knew he threw it well. He starts to run it out. 10-pin lead. Guppy has the advantage with the outside angle. And as he clapped his hand there, he sent a $200 wristwatch back in the stands for a souvenir for somebody. But he can recover it with a victory just in this game.
Again, it's a 4-7-10 on that left lane.
The contrasting styles show up right away. That outside line of Troop does not give him much margin of error to hit the 1-3 pocket. When he gets there, he should carry. That time there, he left the 4-7-10. He needs to hit the 4-pin on this side and slide it over into the 10-pin area, 12-1 shot.
So you saw the 4-7 go. It's an open frame after a double. Now, Guppy Troop trails by 5 and a Texas, an all-American city adjacent to the big town of Dallas. Trask shooting, leading by 5. Fourth frame, strike up. Tom Baker and we'll meet the winner. Keeps warming up to the right.
Set up, honey. Come on.
Trask actually having trouble on the right-hand lane. I asked him before we started the championship round which lane he felt hooked the most, and he said the left-hand lane. And although he's out there and I'm up here, I think he figured him wrong, Chris. Ted Hannes, who's our tournament leader, had the pair figured absolutely correct. He's got the right-hand lane hooking more. It's right now giving our Trask some trouble. And once you get your mind set that you think one hooks more than the other, it's hard to change it.
Hook. That's why. Thank you.
No.
And we see every mistake he makes. He's figuring the lane's going to go straight, and here the ball. He figured the ball would slide back into the 3-6. He should have hit it right here in the 3-6 area and had the 6 go into the 10, but not so. He let the ball get away from him, hook in that track area, which we said hooks a little more, chops the 3-6 and leaves the 10.
And trails by 7. Trying now to recover on the left lane, 5th frame, 2nd match. Art won the first over Batone, 195 to 184. No, just slid by. 2, 4, 5, 7.
One of the really difficult spares, as Melanie Trask looks on, for the pros to make. The 2, 4, 5 or any of those combinations is fairly easy. But when you add the 7 pin, you have the possibility of hanging the 7 or chopping the 2, 4, 7 combination off of the 5.
Feebly. Gets them all.
Good shot. You want us to go to the left. You have to take a chance on going by. Art Trask made the good shot. The 2-pin takes out the 5.
Now after an open frame, Guppy Troop in the 5th frame, leading by 7. Just like it was on a string. I think he liked it. Looking for a re-rag now.
The reason that I feel, Chris, that these pins carry more consistently on the solid pocket hits, these pins here have a sirloin cover on it, and our lane maintenance crew has told me that as they wear, they seem to swell up, and the bellies get a little bigger than normal, and so it's easier to knock down the pins on a solid hit. But once again, he leaves needs a 3-pin to need a re-rag, Chris.
While that happens, earlier we asked Troop, why does he wear such wild pants?
I wear the unique slacks because it goes with the name. When you got a name like Guppy, the slacks just came along with it, and everybody in the audience seems to like it a lot, and I get a lot of following that way.
And being a Scotsman, it's pretty close to one of the plaids, tartans. Big double. And a 17-pin lead, and D is happy.
Art Trask has to collect his thoughts. He's going to have to make a move to the left on the left on the right-hand lane, lane 40 here at Grand Prairie, and make a move to the right on the left-hand lane. Let's see what he does. He's behind by 17, behind an experienced Guppy Troop.
Better.
Stubborn 7.
The wall shot. The head pin goes to sideboard. It wants to take out the 4, 7, and 5. It just slides by the 7. Easy spare for our Trask.
Big week here in Grand Prairie at the Forum Bowl, Junior Bowling, Pro-Am, you name it. Really promote a game of bowling on every level.
All right, Kerry.
Again, he gets his wish. Art Trask with that strike in the 7th frame, still trailing by 18. More of the second match following this. What a Sunday lineup here on ABC tomorrow, beginning with Superstars, followed by Wide World of Sports, a special edition, live coverage from Honolulu of the Pro Bowl. That's tomorrow. Troop leading by 18 has a double working shooting in the seventh frame. Ten pin.
The weak 10, the ball didn't quite finish, and Guppy, if he had gotten that one, would have jumped over the ball return rack. He's an exciting player, and when he's hot, he is very tough to beat. On this championship pair, Guppy had a 245 average during the 42-game format.
No trouble with the 10 pin, but it's getting late, and Guppy with the 17 pin lead will be shooting next, as you see, in the eighth frame of our second game. Last year, Guppy finished fifth, whereas his opponent in the second match won the Quaker State Open. Both pros had outstanding 1982 seasons play. High hit, the 6-10.
Troop with a difficult angle of the pocket, that outside line. If he lets it go just a little bit, it breaks through. He got an excellent break by not leaving the 4-6 split. Changes to a hard ball, cross lane for the 6-10.
All right, the pro bowler born in Edinburgh, Scotland. And now Art Trask is asking for a re-rec. Listen.
That looks perfect to me, Art. Okay.
And Harry Golden says it very simply. It looks perfect.
Crucial shot for Art Trask. He trails by 15, has a strike working. Eighth frame can cut the lead of Guppy Troop down to just 5.
Big shot for a 175-pounder.
Carry ball.
That time, his wish wasn't answered. He left the 4-pin.
Once again, he's looking for the right-hand lane to what we call set up, and that means the ball stopped right there in the 1-3, but it bites just enough on the back end and hooks high. Our tournament leader has that lane figured to hook a little bit more. Art Trask is playing for it to be tighter.
Two games, and the pros are looking to trip a few fours. They've had a little trouble with that here today. Trask trailing by 15. And these bowlers really check out the score sheets to get the current situation.
Trask going at a 187 pace, Guppy Troop at 202. The match is still up for grabs.
Believe Trask, 10 pin left lane.
Thanks.
Reaction? How often have you had that reaction?
Take that.
Our Rolaids tip of the week has to do with junior bowling. And that's going to be very interesting for you young folks, boys and girls, that have taken up this sport. So be sure and watch Bo and his tiny young friend go through the tip of the week. Got a break. In profile, we replay Troop's shot.
Guppy carries that solid 10 out. Guppy with that outside line has a 71% carry percentage so far in his match, where Art Trask has dropped to 58%, and that shows the difference in the line they're playing to the pocket, Chris. Mm-hmm. The outside line of Troop has been the dominant factor so far. He can shut out Art Trask with a mark right here.
Best kind of mark in bowling. Big pocket hit, 10th frame strike. So it appears that Guppy is going to better his fifth place finish a year ago, and that the defending champion has found trouble, needs 6 pins right here. Gets 10, and a victory, and
for Art Trask, a check for $6,000, finishing fourth. So it's going to be these Wide World of Sports next. And Guffey Troop has eliminated Art Trask, shooting 222 to Trask's 183, Trask winning the first 195 to 184. So Tom Baker now goes against Guffey Troop, a step closer to the $20,000 first prize. We mentioned our Rolaids tip of the week had to do with junior bowling. Nelson has a youngster, about 6 years old, that he's going to give some tips to. And by the way, I want to remind you that the tips that Bo is going to give to this youngster can apply to you as an adult, too. So let's sit back, watch, and listen to this tip.
The Professional Bowler's Tip of the Week is brought to you by Rolaids.
On many of our professional bowling telecasts, Chris and I have talked about bowling being a sport for all ages. Today's tip is for the junior bowler, the young bowler who is not old enough to take a full approach or even strong enough to grip the bowling ball. Now, young Greg here does like many other young bowlers, rolls the ball down the lane without putting his fingers in the hole. Greg, let's see your style, partner. Nobody likes the gutter ball. Everybody likes success in bowling. And this is where you parents can come in. When you have a youngster who can't put his hands in the ball yet and use the finger and thumb hole to roll it down the lane and has to roll with two hands, show them how to balance the ball for a nice, smooth, equal roll on the lane. Now, all bowling balls are not equally balanced. What you must do is teach your child to position the ball so that it will roll between the thumb and finger holes. That way you get a nice, consistent, even roll down the lane. Greg, let's see your shot.
Roger Staubach for Rolaids.
Although he's stuck at the line, he gets them all, and the match is all even. The winner of this will meet the tournament leader, Ted Hannes, who led all the way in the top 24 qualifying finals to get the five people that you're seeing here today on our live telecast from Grand Prairie. But right now, it's Troop and Baker. Leaving the 6-10.
Troop wasting no time gets a hard ball so he can make it skid across the lane and hopefully avoid the chop.
Now Baker is back. Baker opened with a strike, now shooting in the second. Five titles in his 7 years. His hobby? Playing and watching hockey. A double. Tom Baker of Buffalo. Now he is asking for free rack and gets it. For Tom, it's his first championship round appearance this year. He has bowled in all three previous events. Last year, he made five championship round finals. Won the Grand Prix, AMF Grand Prix in Paris. So, two international winners here as we look at Tom's wife, Lisa. Troop won at a Canadian event last year. And here he is now, opening with a strike, a spare in the second, shooting in the third, trailing.
The action's picked up. Two experienced players, Tommy Baker, aggressive. Tommy is the fifth all-time money winner in the last 3 years on the Pro Bowlers Tour, and he hasn't really gained the notoriety of some of the other stars because he's done most of it in the summertime, but He is quite a player. Guppy Troop, never a man to give up. Could cut that lead down to just 10 pins with another strike.
And wearing those shades. Clutch bowling here in our semifinal match. Going to leave live action. We're running behind.
Fourth left a solid 10, marked with a spare after 3-12. All right, four strikes. There's five frames for Buffalo's Tom Baker. Now, Baker really looks sharp, Chris. I've seen him many times get too slow. He's a methodical bowler, but when he keeps his... And he keeps the speed up on the ball. He's difficult as Guppy Troop comes up in the lane in frame five to take the lead with another strike. Guppy Troop.
We're sorry, but there's a temporary technical problem on today's live telecast of the Pro Bowlers Tour. We will continue, though, with the audio portion and will resume as soon as possible.
He has a one-pin lead at this point because he has strung three.
Now our video portion is back. Sixth frame coming up for Troop of Jacksonville, Florida. Negative four bagger for the man in the previous game eliminated Art Trask, the defending champion, 222 to 183 with eight strikes. Baker back up, strike working, shooting in the sixth frame. Trailing by 11. Cut it to one with a strike here. Careful, very methodical.
Semi-fingertip grip. Not the full fingertip. He's under control.
What a match, our semifinal. One pin now separating these two pros.
Solid in the pocket. You'll see just a perfect hit. Watch the ball just hits the 1, 3, 5, and 9, and the other pins do the work. 10 in the pit. Tommy Baker looks as sharp as anybody I've seen all year. He could now retake the lead with a strike here.
And he did just that. Great year thus far. Owns a trotter named Top Cash In with two victories here in 83. Well, we'll be back with more of the semifinal match following this. With a big shot is a four-bagger working, shooting in the seventh frame, trailing by 9. Strike here will give him the lead. Getting tough. 5 in a row in the semifinal match. The winner to meet the tournament leader, Ted Hannes. One pin.
The experienced player and the action has picked up. Tommy Baker is 85% on pocket hits so far through 7 frames with 6 out of 7. Guppy Troop is 85% for the whole day. And he's right up there in this match pushing old Tommy Baker. He leads by 1.
Six in a row and an 11-pin lead, putting the pressure on 28-year-old Tom Baker. Tom has a three-bagger up, and he'll be shooting now in the eighth frame of the semifinal match. Loser of this match, $7,500. The winner goes into the final, a chance for $20,000. Four in a row for Tom Baker. He's not going to let Troop get away.
The scoreboard tells a story. The only difference so far is the solid 10-pin that Baker left in the fourth frame. Chris, he has just laid every ball in the pocket with such precision. Definitely the best performance we've seen so far this year. Baker will not give this match to Troop. Troop will have to go out and take it. Right now, if they both struck out, Baker would have a 279, Troop a 280. Anything can happen. Only one pin separate the players, 2 frames to go.
And the wives are side by side in this capacity crowd. As the husbands go to work. Lots of pressure. Ninth frame, Baker. And 8-pin. Maybe a little less speed on that stroke.
The inside line of Tommy Baker playing around the third arrow, swinging the ball out into the track area. Right there, it's biting around the 12th board and gets one of the all-time bad breaks we've seen all year. Solid in the pocket, the solid 8-pin. He needs to convert this just a trail bite, just two sticks. Baker has not had a good break yet today. He's still in the match.
Now it is Guppy Troop, winner of one match. Very confident, getting on the approach. 6 in a row, now the ninth. Ten pin.
It's going down to the very last ball. Guppy Troop with a conversion right here would be going at a 249 pace. Tommy Baker right now is going at 248. The half 10 doesn't quite get all the way up to the pocket. Watch the 6-pin lay down in the channel. Could have bounced out, but no break.
Cross lane. Between them, they have 10 PBA titles. Tommy Baker of Buffalo, Guppy Troop of Jacksonville, Florida.
By far the best match we've had all year. Whoever can perform in a 10th will take the match. If we'd happen to have a tie, as we did in the championship last year here at the Quaker State, we would go into a two-frame roll-off.
The final game yet to be played. Well, we're starting to run them out now as tension mounts, excitement builds here at the Forum.
Guppy Troop, one of the great clutch players we have on the tour, and Tommy Baker also, so it's whoever can throw him. Guppy Troop could shut out Baker with three strikes, but he needs this one in the second to take the lead by 11. 11th frame.
Tremendous bowling here in the semifinal match. Getting a sip of H2O. It's hot out there.
The golden arm swing of Guppy Troop. He dropped that ball, but direction and accuracy are 95% of any game played with a ball, and it ended up right in the pocket. If he strikes here, he'll shut out Baker with a 259. If he doesn't strike, he still might lose.
Pressure. Tommy Baker looking away. Three pin, a 258 for Guppy Troop.
The situation for powerful Tommy Baker is he must strike on the next three balls to tie.
It's a big order.
He's been solid in the pocket every frame so far.
And as you said, without a break. So Guppy Troop with a 258 goes into the final against the tournament leader, Ted Hannes. The Professional Bowlers Tour will continue after this message from one of our sponsors and station identification. Nine strikes, bowling a 258 to Tom Baker's 236. 17 strikes for Troop in two matches now. 6'2" Ted Hanna steps in as we look at the finishers, 6 through 24.
Alvin Liu, 136, his last game, got knocked out. Ernie Schlegel, nice to see him back up there. Bankball Bob, Dale Eagle flapping his wing. Clean cut, David Houston, Steve Martin up there. Mark Baker doing well. Bill Spigner up there. Steve Neff stroking real well. Murdershaw, Ed Wallace, the conventional power player. Billy Young, Jeff Morin from Cleveland up there. Frank Allenberg, the Masters champion. Mr. 300, Steve Wunderlich up there. And John Forrest from LaGrange, Illinois, near St. Louis, round out the top 24. 25th was my old buddy, shortcut Sam Zurich, finished 25th. They paid 48 spots this week, Chris, with $800 going to the 48th finisher.
So the practice shots are completed here.
the big final game worth $20,000 to the winner, $11,000 to the loser, and it's Ted Hannes, who last year, without a victory, earned $93,000, fourth on the money list. He's on the left. Guppy Troop will shoot first. Other finishers, Pete Weber, 28th, Holman, 30th, Roth, 36th, and Gary Skidmore, 44th. This is Troop hot. Didn't come up, slid by the 2-4-5.
Let's see what that performance last game took out of Guppy Troop. Sometimes you press so hard that in the last match you don't, can't get it together, and he's going against a tough player in Ted Hannes. The 2-4-5, the head pin goes to sideboard, takes out the 7 and 8. Got to watch the chop. Guppy with that nice straight shot.
Gets him. He was a little worried, though, and he lost a lot of energy in that last match, as Bo said, because all his emotions were hanging out. They really were. Here now is Ted Hannes. Has one victory in 4 years as a PBA member. He's on the right lane, sneaking up to the line. And zigzagging to the line, and Bo, a beautiful strike.
Chris, he just took over the lead in the third round of qualifying. We have an 18-game qualifier. Ted Hannes averaged an amazing 258, jumped way out in front of the field and never relinquished that lead. This young man is a star of the future. He had 93,000 in winnings last year without ever winning a title. Watch out for him as soon as he starts winning.
Six-game block of 1550, 258 average. Second frame, championship game. A big double for the tournament leader who's had to wait all this time. And there is the legendary Byron Nelson. What a friend, Bo. You know, they often said about him that if you had a blood transfusion from this man, because of the ice water in his veins, you would come down with pneumonia.
You can sure hit that white ball.
Yeah.
Now here's another guy that falls into that category, Chris, Guppy Troop. He is cool under pressure. He has rolled, in 1 year, he rolled a record 6 perfect games on the Pro Bowlers Tour, and he knows how to handle that pressure.
You know, I got to say one more thing about the Squire of Fairway Ranch in nearby Roanoke. He won 11 straight in 45, 18 victories in that same year with an average of 68.3 stroke average.
An all-time record.
Minute and a Scottish jig. Watch this. Profile replay.
Guppy gets the first really great break of the championship match. He was trailing by 10. He had a strike working. Ideal position to see that short swing. Now watch the follow through directly towards the target. Watch that elbow just turn out a little bit, turn sideways, which weakened the shot, but he got a break. Watch how the pins roll around and knocks out the 10. Now it's going to be the head pin. It goes to the left sideboard. Now there it goes. It's almost lost. And here she comes rolling around. That's the what they call the scout shot on the tour. We remember George Pappas carried that strike to win the Firestone 1 year. That's mm-hmm. one of the greatest breaks you can get in bowling.
And Guppy, looking now along with you at Ted Hannes. From Zanesville, Ohio. So it's 3 in a row for our tournament leader. He is the youngest and the biggest in this field of five at 25 and 185 pounds on a 6'2" frame.
Product of the junior program of Ohio. He led the juniors in average in 1975 with a 210 average when he was still a junior bowler. And he has made his mark out on the tour. He's a name to you're going to hear a lot about over the next few years. A cerebral player, Chris. He doesn't beat himself. He thinks hard. And he really believes in himself. He's a joy to be around as his wife looks on.
Julie looks tense. Make it to fourth frame. Four bagger, perfect thus far in the final match. Running a little behind time. Going to leave live action for the moment. We'll keep you in. The 4-7 marked with a spare.
and Hannes, who has four in a row, shooting in the fifth frame with a 12-pin lead. This is the championship match.
Ted Hannes, who has that 18-board drift to the left. He starts way over on the right side, but watch how he repositions everything right at the last moment. He's got a step and a half to go. Look at that shoulder right in behind the shot. Very powerful upper body, tremendous lift on the ball. He gets a good break in that match on that shot to retain a 22-pin lead. He has five in a row, Chris.
Okay, and re-rack on the left lane. And that's where Ted Hannes will be shooting next in this championship match. 20,000 to the winner, 11,000 to the runner-up. 22-pin lead. Now it is the sixth frame. Ted Hannes, 25 years old, is halfway. And if he can go the rest of the way, the true value award of $50,000 will go to him.
That's the second week in a row we've had a possible 300. Remember at the high-scoring showboat lanes last week, there was a possible 300 by Tom Milton.
Now Troop had a spare in the fifth, now shooting in the sixth, trailing by 32. And the man that won the last two matches, Luce, gets a strike. Looking at the score sheet of Frank Esposito, as we get the purse breakdown, total purse of $125,000. There you see Tom Baker with $7,500, Vitone with $5,000. Hey! Trying to stay as close as he can with a double. Guppy Troop. They are really perspiring now. As we get a replay of that hit, Nelson, explain it.
The two-pin goes to the sideboard, Chris, and trips out to 4-7. Guppy Troop really has one of the greatest carrying balls in the tour, and he is just loose. People ask me, and I've always wondered, how a player gets tremendous carry like that. I think it was just born in him. They just relax when they roll the ball, and the pins know, seem to know that he wants to carry, and no problem at all for Guppy.
And next here on ABC, 5 Eastern, 4 Central, ABC's Wide World of Sports, including the United States Figure Skating Championships from Pittsburgh. We're at the Quaker State Open. Hannes, 7th frame. It's a 2-8. The string is stopped at 6.
But the match is still in doubt. Right now, Guppy Troop's going at a 2:28 pace. Ted Hannes at a 2:48 pace. Only 20 pins separate the players, but Hannes faced with the difficult 2-8 double wood spare.
Only one 300 this week, Tim Campbell. Covers the sleeper as well as the two. Pressure, Guppy Troop now. Getting another swig of that water. It's hot out there. Byron Nelson keeps checking that score sheet. He knows about it.
He says he can't handle the pins too much with a bowling ball, but give him a 5-iron, he'll do a job on him.
Retired at 34 years of age. Well, don't see that too often, the 6-9-10.
A letdown for Ted Hannes. He was not only going for the title, but he was going for the match. And when he left the 2-8 in the seventh frame, he just seemed to ease up here in the eighth. Gets a good break. He actually could have had a wide open split, a 5-pin split, but he pushes out the 4-7, has to guard against the chop on this cross lane shot. Thank you.
Just as you indicated, Bo.
He was blocking it out. He didn't want to chop the six off the nine or the ten, and all of a sudden the match is completely turned around. Guppy Troop can take the lead with another strike, as we see Hannah's just completely missed to the left. Really surprised me, Chris. This kid, Hannah's, is a strong young man, and he very seldom makes mistakes like that, but he has opened the door for Guppy Troop.
Because Guppy has a double up, and he is shooting in the eighth frame, getting late in this championship game.
And again, the carry of that non-lustrous blue bowling ball. And what a man on the other end of the ball, Guppy Troop.
The story of the pinfall. Guppy Troop playing that outside line has maximized the pinfall in what most of the players considered tough pinfall. He's playing that extreme outside line. Watch the head pin go to the sideboard. You'll see that 4, 5, 7 gets the great break, the wall shot to take the lead. He has 5-pin lead. He could extend to 15, ninth frame.
Left to 10 on the left lane.
Wife Dean looks on. Guppy Troop, 88% strike carry power percentage this week from that outside line. That's definitely been the difference in the matches. He has carried the strikes consistently.
And for Guppy, a spare in the ninth frame. And Bo, you professionals have left something of merit here. You have for the past 7 years, because proceeds from the Quaker State Open Tournament have been donated to the Texas Scottish Rite Hospital for Crippled Children. It's received more than $50,000 from this tournament, which this year is co-sponsored by the Dallas-Fort Worth Bowling Proprietors Association. And I know you made my friend Jim Chambers very happy by doing what you do, what sports does for the handicapped.
And Jeannie Halsey also behind that. Over $50,000 for the children. Hannah's trails in the match by 4.
All right, and a very close match. Ted Hannah's with a strike in the ninth, a big one.
Ted Hannah's, as you see him line up, looks like he's going to throw the ball down the right channel. But as he walks, you'll see he drifts over 18 boards and actually is playing a medium inside line. See this drift, 18 boards. And he got that because he tried to shorten his approach. And instead of shortening it 3 feet, he just decided to walk almost 3 feet to the left and made the compensation. Right now, he can take the lead in the match. He needs this strike. 10th frame.
Remember, he opened with 6 in a row. Spare, an open frame, a strike in the ninth. Left to 4.
The match is not over yet. With a spare and a strike, Ted Hannah's would have a 2-33. That would force Guppy Troop to mark 17 pins in the 10th frame. It's still not over. Hannah's must convert this spare to stay in the match.
Difference of $9,000, winning or losing, plus a trophy and a replica of a race car. Blew it.
Chris, he just missed the spare. The match is over. Guppy Troop wins, sitting on the bench. Unbelievable. Guppy can't believe it. He was all prepared for having to throw a stroke.
Guppy trying to give Ted Hannah's some consolation, but what can you say for a 25-year-old, the youngest and the biggest in this final field of 5, 2 crucial errors, 221 for Zanesville, Ohio's Ted Hannah's.
Really surprised me, Chris. I know Ted and his father at home have to be disappointed. Guppy just has to keep it on the lane, and he is the winner of the 7th Quaker State Open.
Needed 8, got 10, and a very emotional Guppy Troop. 5 victories coming into the Quaker State Open. He finished 5th last year. Jeannie Halsey, who owns the 60 lane establishment with its chandeliers, gets a hug from the winner of the $20,000 first prize, a trophy, a miniature race car. What a final match. We'll be back. $20,000, 6th victory for Guppy Troop. Along with us here on the approach, Walter B. Cook, Executive Vice President of Quaker State Oil Refining Corporation. Spoils of victory, Mr. Cook.
Thank you. Well, Guppy, congratulations on a championship performance from the Quaker State family.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
The Quaker State family includes our distributors, the thousands of retailers, and the millions of motorists who make our participation here possible by making Quaker State number one.
Okay, $20,000. Our time is running out, Walter.
I don't know what to say, Genie. I told you I'd win this thing sooner or later. I want to thank scorekeepers. I had the whole crowd behind me all week, and I want to tell my lawyer thanks for not coming in. And
good luck, D. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the final score. Guppy Troop, the winner, 237-221. Stay tuned next for ABC's Wide World of Sports featuring United States Figure Skating Championships, the Superbikes Finals, and a Pro Bowl preview. Travel arrangements made through a promotion fee paid by United Airlines. United flies more people to Hawaii than any other airline. That's what friendly skies are all about. This has been an ABC Sports presentation.